Hey everyone, welcome again. In this video, we will discuss about a problem and then we will see what are all possible solutions for that problem. And then after that, we will develop that problem with the help of our Apex trigger. So first, let's see what is a problem statement. In our contact standard object, user are able to see duplicate records with some information based on fields like email, name, first name, last name. So these are some basic criteria where user is, whenever user is running a report, user is able to see some duplicate records. What a developer needs to do is to build a solution so that we can prevent duplicate records while a user, any user that is system admin, sales representatives, or some other user is trying to enter the information into Salesforce system. For that, what all possible solutions we have is, first is duplicate rules. We can quickly go ahead and create a duplicate rule with the help of point and click. And then the other option that we have is Apex trigger. Duplicate rule doesn't require any coding knowledge. You can develop that with the help of point and click from the setup. And then Apex trigger requires a coding knowledge. We need to find out which particular solution is best for your problem. So let's first quickly see what is a problem with our duplicate rules. If we are developing a duplicate rule into the system to prevent the duplicate records, what problem we will get into? Because if any problem we can solve with the configuration without coding, we definitely prefer that option. But in this case, with the duplicate, what problem we have is, if a user is trying to undelete a duplicate record from recycle bin, duplicate rule doesn't work. That means, let's say that you have a duplicate record in your system, you have deleted that record from the system, and then now a user is going to recycle bin, and from there user is trying to undelete that record. At that time, duplicate rule will not work. That means, we will again get into the same problem. We will again able to see duplicate records into our system. So if we go back and see the possible solutions, that means this duplicate rule is not for us. We have the second option, that is Apex trigger. In Apex trigger, because we will get the events that will be before insert, before update, and after undelete. And then we will execute that trigger and we will throw the error. So if we see, this will be the approach for us. First thing that we need to do is, we need to get all the records that are either being inserted or updated, so that we can get a list of all records, which records we are going to check, either these records are duplicate or these are the clean records. And the next approach will be, get the emails. Because in this problem or in this solution, we are actually checking with the email. If there is any duplicate email, we are not going to we are going to throw an error to the user that you cannot insert a record with a duplicate email on the same object. So first thing that we will do is, we will fetch all those records, we will iterate with those records, and then add those values into a set, and we will name it as new email set. Next step that will be, make a SQL on contact object so that we can get existing record. If there is any existing record based on that email, so that we can get those. And then again iterate with the list that we are getting on the step number 3. Add those emails into a new set and name it as existing email set. Now we have two email set. One is new, that are brand new, where we are performing the operation insert or update. And the second set that we have is a list of all email that exist in the system. And then we will iterate with the new record list that we are getting from step 1. And we will check if the email, the new email is new email is there present in our existing email set, we will throw an error to the user. So first thing that we will do is, we will quickly check the problem with the duplicate rule, and then we will advance, we will work with our Apex trigger. So let's quickly check. So this is our environment where we have already developed a duplicate rule. But let me quickly walk you through where the duplicate rule is. If you go to setup and you will find type duplicate rule on the quick search box, you will find duplicate rules and matching rules. So you need to click on duplicate rule, click on that, and this is a duplicate rule that is active. So let's quickly open this, and based on few criteria like account name, first name, last name and email, this duplicate rule is based on these four criteria. If all these four fields will match, we will get an error. So let's quickly we are not going to go deep into duplicate rules. Let's quickly see. We already have two duplicate records with the same name, same account name. And then again, we will try to add one more, or we will try to edit a record. Let's quickly say that I'm just trying to edit the birth date. I will try to save this, and we are able to save record. Why? Because this is an edit operation, and the duplicate rule is not able to find, because we are not making any change on the fields which our duplicate rule is set up. So if we go back and we check account, first name, last name, email, we are not making any changes on this. This is why we are not getting. Now let's try to clone this record, and after cloning, don't make any changes. This will be a complete duplicate record, and now we will get the error. And here it is saying that we have two possible duplicate records. These are those two possibles. And we are also getting red color sign over the field name, email, account name, last name, whatever all whatever we have. So this is now. Let's quickly go ahead, save this. We are going to ignore the alert. We will try to save, and we will delete this record. Open this contact as well, because we don't want any duplicate record into our system. Just going to clean that. After cleaning, let's quickly go back to the recycle bin that we discussed. Select one contact record and undelete it. And you will see that we are successfully able to undelete that record. We did not get any error that this is a duplicate record. So this was the problem with our duplicate rule, and that we are going to tackle with the Apex trigger. So let's quickly create a trigger that we already have. If you don't have any trigger into your system, you can quickly click on File, New, go to Apex trigger, give it a name, and then for the S object, you need to select contact from the list of objects. And then you can say that duplicate contact trigger. But as per a best practice, we only need to create one record, one trigger in a particular object. This is why we are not going to create a new trigger. Now let's quickly comment out this code and start working or start implementing our steps that we discussed while we were on PPT. So first step was get a list of all new records. Before that, we need to find out what are all the operations where our trigger is going to execute. So there might be a possibility that we are inserting a new duplicate record. There might be a possibility that a user is editing an existing record, and then we are getting into a duplicate records. For that, we also need to put before insert, because we don't want to user to let insert the record before update. And one thing that we discuss is that is after undelete, because we don't want a user also to undelete a duplicate record from recycle bin. So these are all three. And now what we need to do is, first thing that we need to do is get list of all new records. So we all know that trigger.new is a context variable that returns list of S object. And in our case, our object is contact, so it will return list of contact. Now we also have three different events: before insert, before update, and after undelete. So what we will do is We will quickly create a list of contact. We will say that list of contact and name it as contact list. Now what we will do is we'll put if statement here, and we will say that if trigger dot is before and trigger dot is insert. That means it is for insert operation, before insert. So you don't need to put your mind very hard, like how you are going to put this condition. It is very easy. You just need to check your operations, sorry, check your events, and your event is like before insert. So here it will be trigger dot is before and then trigger dot is insert. And then after, what we need to do is we again need to check for update as well. So we are going to say here, let's quickly name it as here or trigger dot is update. So now on both the cases we will get trigger dot new, contact list equal to trigger dot new. Even in our after and delete case, we will also get trigger dot new. But there might be some possibilities, like we wanted to execute some other code on undelete. So this is why we are putting that in a separate if law, separate condition. So we will say that is after and trigger dot is undelete, and then we are going to again use the same line of code. First step, our first step is done. Now next step is that we need to do is we need to create a set of a string where we are going to say we discuss that we need to find exist new email set. So we will say that new email set, and then we need to iterate. So and then add this new emails into our email set. So now let's quickly iterate with our contacts that we are getting. So we will say that contact list, and then here we will put a check for if there is email, there is email on the contact, then only we are going to add that into our set. Let's copy this. Now we are done with step 2. We can also put it here. Step 2, add new emails into a set. And why we are using set? So that we don't get duplicate emails into the list. Now step 3 is make a SQL on contact object to get the duplicate records. Right, now we need to again say that let's make our list of contact, and we will say that existing contact list, and then make a query and select ID email from contact, and we need to filter based on these emails, and I will explain you why we need to filter based on these emails. So we will say that where email in these emails. So because if we don't put any filter while making a SQL into our contact object, we will get list of all contacts that are available into the system, but we only want to get only those contacts that have the same email ID. This is why we are putting a filter on based on our email, because our duplicate criteria is on email field. If our duplicate criteria was based on some composite fields that we discussed in our duplicate rule, like it was account name, first name, last name and emails, then we need to put four filters based on those four fields. And how it will work? So let's quickly suppose this. We have three contacts, and we can say that three new contact. And in the system that we have is, let's say that 10,000 contact. And now if we are not putting any filter here while making SQL, we will get all 10,000 contacts. And what will happen, let's say that if we have three contacts, and we are going to say that these were emails respectively for each of the contacts. Let's say that these were all three contacts into the system, and these contacts doesn't have any of these emails. We are not making any, we are not putting any filter. We are getting 10,000 records. That is going to impact our performance as well. If we are putting filter based on these emails, we are going to get zero records, because there is no records with these matching criteria. That means there is no duplicate rules. We don't need to check any further. We don't need to execute our further logic. This is why we are putting filters here. Now, next thing that we need to do is, let's quickly replicate this set, and we will name it as existing email set. Now let's quickly iterate with these lists that we have is on the step 4. So this is, we can also put one more filter, and email is not equal to null. Even we are putting filter on email field itself, we don't want to get any contact that doesn't have email. Now we are going to add, we will say that existing email set dot add, and we will add existing contact email here. Now we can say that we are done with step 4. Now we have step 5 is to check if this email contains any of the emails, sorry, this email set contains any emails, any of out of these contacts. How this is going to work? Let's quickly put step 5 here as well. So we will say that step 5, and we again need to iterate over contact list, and this time we are going to iterate with contact list, that is our new record, the list that we are inserting or updating. Now here how it is going to work is, we just need to put a simple check. We are going to say that if our set dot contains, what it does contain is contact email. Now this existing email set is different with our new email set, because new email set will contains all the emails that we are inserting, but existing email set will contains only the information about those contacts that are already there in the system and all duplicate records. Now here we can quickly put, we can say that con dot email dot add error, because we wanted to show the error on email fields, and we can say that duplicate emails, email is not allowed. Now if we test it, we are getting some errors. Okay, it should be here. Now if we try to test this trigger, we should able to get an error. Now let's quickly try to clone this again, make some changes on, we can say that we are going to remove the account, because on the account we also have we are running the duplicate rule. So let's quickly try to save it, but we still should be able to get the error because of our trigger. And the error that we are getting is, whatever we had we given in our trigger. Now let's quickly deactivate this duplicate rule. You might be thinking that we are done. This is super easy. Yes, it is super easy, but there is still one thing pending. And what that one thing is, let's quickly try to create two records from our anonymous window. That means we are trying to cover what if we are inserting a record in a bulk and that bulk record, that list or the file that we have is, those files have duplicate records. How we are going to tackle that? So what we need to do is, let's quickly say that contact, and we are trying to create duplicate records here. So we'll say that last name duplicate, and we are going to say email here is test@gmail.com, and we again going to replicate this line. Just quickly change duplicate second, and then we will create a list of record, sorry, list of contact, where we are going to say new list of contact, and then add here both two variables. It will be con1. Now let's try to insert those, that list here. Execute highlighted. We are not getting any error. Earlier we tested. Why we are getting that error? Because there was a record already exist on the same email address. But now why we are not getting any error? Because we are doing a bulk operation and there is no record based on that email address. This is why we are not getting that error. Here we have both the duplicate errors, records. Even now, if you try to edit your record, we should be able to get that error. So let's quickly change some phone here. I'm going to change the first name or last name as well. You will get that error, duplicate emails are not allowed. Why? Because this time we are checking on existing record. We are not checking on the brand new records. So to tackle this or to resolve this problem, what we need to do is, there is no rocket science behind this. We just need to put one else condition here, and that we are going to say, if existing email set contains email, that is well and good, we have duplicate records. If that doesn't contains, let's quickly add new email into our existing email so that we can be sure that now our existing email set is up to date and we are not getting any duplicate records. How it is going to happen? Let's quickly do a mock here. Consider the first criteria that we discussed, that we executed. Let's say that both email address we have is, now let's quickly change these email address. These are the brand new email address that we are trying to insert. First time this record will come, it will check, does existing email set contains, it will check for this condition, does this existing email set contains this email, and the answer will be false. That means no, it doesn't contain. It will bypass this condition and it will not throw an error. Now on this email set we are getting, now this first time, let's quickly say first time this email set is blank, there is nothing in this set. Now after executing this condition, in this email set we have this. Next time when this logic will get executed, it will say that yes, we do have that email. Now let's throw an error that there is duplicate records. This way we are also preventing that a file where we have duplicate records, we are also going to throw this error. Now let's quickly let's wait to save this record, and then again we will try to execute this piece of code with our new email ID that we just saw here. Now let's quickly try to execute this code. See, now we are getting the error field custom validation exception, and it is saying that duplicate email is not allowed. Field name is email, and none of the record has been inserted. And to make sure that here, because we made the same last name, we are going to again execute highlight. We are getting an error. If you go to contact record, you will not see that duplicate record. Now let's quickly get back. Delete this record. We are replicating that recycle bin scenario. Select, undelete, and we will get that error here itself. Unable to undelete one record because you will say a data integrity apex trigger would fail if the record was undeleted. You may have no longer access to record to undelete. So these are the Salesforce defined error that Salesforce gives us, that these are the possible errors that we are not able to delete that record from recycle bin, and we are not able to restore that record into the main object from where a user can access that record. So we are also able to tackle this error as well. So this was a very easy way, a very super easy way to implement a duplicate records. Now even if you want to prevent duplicate records on lead object based on email, first name, last name or account name, you can also quickly do that. What hint I will do is, we have created only one email set for new email set. If you are trying to put validation rule based on three fields like first name, last name, or so, you can say that new first name set, and here you can say that new last name set. And then while making the so-called on the object, you need to put the conditions here, and those conditions will be based on and, because we wanted to check if all three fields matches. So you need to put those conditions here. You will say that first name is new first name set, and last name is new last name set. So these are the additional conditions that you need to put. Whatever the logic or whatever the complex scenario that you wanted to achieve here, you can do that. So consider this as your assignment. Try to replicate the same into your lead object, but the condition that you need to apply is, try to find out the duplicate records based on lead email, first name, last name, and company name. Forget about the last part. Don't check for the company name, but check for at least these three fields: email, first name, and last name. So this is it for this lecture, for this video. Hope you have learned how to work with logic building and how to break the problem into the different parts, and then resolve those parts, and then club those solutions into a single to work as a single unit. If you have any problems, please feel free to put your put under the comment section, or you can directly contact me. Thank you.